Thanks for tuning in to another episode of the Naina Redhu Experience. Today we are talking about barter. I am not sure if I've talked about it earlier, but it recently came up because I sometimes on my social media, like on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, I will put up posts saying, looking for barter collaborations. And I usually also include all details, like, is it going to cost money? Then I don't say barter, obviously. But if it's barter, then I'll say that one Instagram update and, you know, your product. And please write to me on email for further details. So I did that. And a few weeks after that, I also bitched about someone writing to me and saying, we want these things from you and this is barter based on Instagram. So one of the people who follow me on Instagram, they're actually a professor, and they wrote to me saying that, you know, how come on the one hand you say that, you know, brands should not write to influencers for barter, and on the other hand, you're also yourself reaching out to brands for barter. And I was like, oh, wow. I mean, I had kind of thought of that, like, vaguely earlier, and I kind of knew that one was okay and the other was not. But it was very interesting when she wrote to me, because it forced me to kind of articulate why one is okay and why is not. So first, I'm going to talk about what actually barter is these days, and from the kind of perspective that I'm talking of, like as an influencer. So what happens is, sometimes a new brand, for example, that I want to work with, okay, as a photographer or as an influencer, I want to work with them, and I get hold of their contact from somewhere, and I write to them and I say that, hey, you know, I'm a photographer, I also have a blog, and I would love to explore and do something with your brand because this is the reason I like it, blah blah blah, whatever. You have to find like a synergy. If there's no synergy and you still really like them, then you have to kind of retrofit it, which is fine. I mean, it's business at the end of the day. But there has to be some context of why you like them. You can't just randomly write to a brand and be like, oh hey, I'm an influencer and, you know, pay me or give me your product. That's like really weird. And it's really dumb. Don't do that. But for example, if there's a brand that you really like, whether it's a fashion brand or it's a mobile brand or whatever, and you always wanted to work with them, you've always wanted to partner with them or showcase their product or kind of tie in your work with what, you know, that brand is. So then you can write to them and say that, hey, you know, I'm so-and-so and I would like to figure out a way to collaborate with you. How can we explore this further? Now, if the brand person is not interested or they're distracted or whatever and it doesn't work out, whatever, that happens all the time. But they might come back to you and say that, oh, hey, you know what, we've never worked with an influencer earlier, or we've never worked with an influencer like you earlier, so like, what do you have in mind, etc. So sometimes it is, especially if it's a brand that you really want to work with, I think it's okay to pitch a barter collaboration. You can say that, oh hey, you know, I really like your brand. For example, if it's a garment label, and you can say that I for example work with a lot of made in India indie brands, etc. And I'll be like, oh hey, I'll see something on Instagram, I'll be like, fuck, that's beautiful, I really want to wear that, I really want it in my wardrobe. It'll be a nice brand to introduce to the people who follow me. I know there are friends who will look at that and be like, aray, ye hame chahiye. So I'll write to them and I'll be like, hey, you know, I would love to work with you guys. How do you guys normally work? Have you worked with influencers earlier in terms of your target audience? Who do you guys want to like reach out to, etc.? And then they'll be like, okay, you know, this is how we do it. Do you have like a marketing budget, etc.? And then they'll be like, no, we don't really have a budget. Usually these brands are like really small. But I will say that, okay, fine, you know, would you be okay working on like a barter where you share your lookbook with me? I will pick an ensemble, like head to toe look, and I will wear it and I will post it on Instagram. I might include it in a blog post when I'm writing about something else, when I wear it in real life. And in general, whenever I wear it, I'll probably tag you guys. So then the brand, you know, then it's up to them. And then they might say, oh, okay, this works for us. Or like, oh no, you know, we can't really afford to do that either. In which case, okay, fine, you know, it doesn't work sometimes. So there, in that sense, it's, you know, whenever I put a call out and I say that, okay, barter collaborations, I want clothes to wear, shoes to wear, and I'll post it on Instagram. That's me putting out barter collaboration requests on my social media, right? I'm not writing directly to a brand. I'm not calling up people and saying, hey, you give me a product and this is what I'll do. You know, it's me saying, okay, I'm open to doing barter collaborations with some brands. If you think you would like me to do that, please write to me. So I think that discussion with that person on Instagram eventually ended up being in that sense that we both realized that it was about consent. So I know, don't roll your eyes. Consent is everywhere these days, which is like, thank God, finally. It's about consent in the sense that, you know, when a brand that I know nothing about, they have never approached me earlier, they've never said hello earlier, I've never met anybody from the team earlier. When they write to me and they say, they give me like a long list of deliverables that they expect, and they say that we will do barter. Like, no, that's not how this works. You can't just write to me and say, these are the 15 things we want and barter is like one pair of shoes. Like, I mean, no. You know, it's like you haven't even written to me and asked me that, hey, we like your brand, we like what Naina.co does, we like that particular blog story you did, that Instagram update was fabulous. You have no idea who I am. You've just picked my name from a list of influencers that you probably got from somewhere and you're like, ye chahiye hame aur hum ye denge. You have to, it's like a, you know, you ask, like, would you be okay doing a barter with us? Maybe like one Insta update for our product or something like that. It's an exploration. You can't just write to someone. I mean, you know, so we were discussing and I was like, what kind of an anecdote should I give? And it was a bit of a shitty anecdote. It's like if someone rings the doorbell, okay? And I open the door and it's my regular courier delivery guy who comes and delivers my Amazon deliveries all the time. And I see him and it's really hot outside and he's sweating and his clothes are torn. And I'm like, bhaiya, aapko pani chahiye, bhaiya, aajao, baitho, khana khao, or something like that. That's me opening the door, offering him to come in, sit down, have a drink of water, take a break for 5 minutes. Usually these guys don't have 5 minutes and they're running around. But that's an offer I am making. It's an invitation. On the other hand, imagine someone rings your doorbell, okay? You open the door and it's a stranger. And you've never seen them before, you have no idea who they are. And they just ring your doorbell and they say, this is my name and you have to now give me lunch and cold water and I'm coming inside that door. Like, I'll probably call the cops if that happens, right? So it's about consent, it's about introducing yourself. I don't think barter, there's anything wrong with barter per se, but it's so contextual. How can you say, arey barter kabhi karna hi nahi chahiye? That's not how it works. I mean, it's based on consent. I will probably write to a brand that, you know, maybe I followed on Instagram and I'll be like, oh my God, I love all the photos. I'll go and like everything there. And be like, fuck it, I really want to work with them. And I look for their email ID. And if I find it, I'll write to them and say that, hey, you know, I saw your stuff on Instagram. I do promote some indie brands and I'd love to figure out a way to work with you guys. What can we do? And it's really easy to tell from their tone that I'm actually fucking excited. Okay. And smaller brands, it's a lot easier also because can you imagine me writing to like an Apple and saying, oh my God, I love the new iPhone X and you know, like, can we do barter? They'll be like, what the fuck are you talking about? Unless I know maybe the marketing head or the brand manager for Apple in India, I'm aware that they are reaching out to influencers or working on a campaign. And I'm aware of, you know, details like that. Maybe I've met them somewhere. Then I can be like, hey, you know what? I'd really love to work with your brand. And what do you think we can do? You know, I'm a photo blogger. I do visual stories and things like that. Is there something that we can do? And then you let them propose something and then you discuss and then you come to like a middle ground. It doesn't just start off by me saying, hey, you know, I am Naina and you should give me an iPhone and I will do an Instagram update. That's not how it works. And it's the same for a brand like writing to me and saying, I mean, I've had so many brands who write to me and they're like, I mean, I don't know you from Adam. Kaun ho? Hello to bolo. Like, kya kaam pasand hai? Like, what? Like, make a fucking introduction, yeah? Like, you don't follow me on Instagram. You've never liked a single picture I've posted. You don't know what my blog looks like. You're asking me, send me, you know, how many followers do you have on all your social media networks? If you have been to my blog even once, that's the first thing you see right on top. It gives you the exact numbers of my social media following. It's there. So it's just rude. And you know, sometimes we talk about that, oh, but you know, you're just giving me a pair of shoes, whereas I charge like X amount of money for an Instagram update. I get it. That does come in, you know, your head, and it should, because at the end of the day, it's business. Ideally, you shouldn't be doing barter at all. But as an introduction, sometimes, you know, if especially if it's a brand that has never worked with an influencer earlier, has no idea how digital marketing or influencer marketing works, with those guys maybe like kind of doing an introduction and saying, okay, see, this is what we did in Barter. You guys have to put in place measurement so that you kind of know how it works, what is the value you're getting out of it. And next time onwards, let's maybe do like a long-term plan where you engage me for 3 months or 6 months. And then you see the kind of value that you actually get out of a comprehensive influencer marketing campaign. So doing a one-off on a Barter or even just saying, okay, I charge this much for an Instagram update and, you know, it doesn't really work in terms of a brand building exercise. It's okay to kind of see if you're exploring how it works, and if you have the money to throw, then sure. Bigger brands tend to have larger budgets for this. So I think from that point of view, when someone writes to me and says, you know, these are the 15 deliverables we want and ye lo 500 rupees ka voucher, that's disgusting. And I am not specifically writing to people and saying, okay, let's do Barter. And out of nowhere. If I do write to someone saying, okay, you know, I'm thinking of doing a Barter collaboration, these are brands I've probably already been working with for like the last 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8 years, and I have built a relationship with. Brands that have already hired me and have paid me for photography or other campaigns, for example. Writing to them and saying that, hey, you know, this season I'm doing like a series on like summer garments, for example, and I want to barter something with you guys. Would you guys be okay with that? I highly doubt any of those brands are going to say no. And I'm okay doing that as well because I know that udhar se waise bhi kaam aa raha hai. You know, so once in a while doing a one-off like this, it's nice. It's like customer client delight. It's fun. But I think the most important thing is consent. If you are not sure as an influencer that the brand might not be okay with it, ask them that, hey, you know, we've never worked together. Do you think it'd be okay to do like a Barter collaboration to kick off things? I'd really love to explore how we can work together. Ask them. Same if you're a brand and you want to reach out to influencers, but you don't know how they work and you've never worked with influencers earlier. Instead of saying, this is a marketing plan our agency has made for us, we're going to give you 500 rupees ka voucher and these are the 50 things we want from you, let's do Barter. Just write to them and say that, hey, you know, we think you do cool work and we want to figure out how we can work together. And then let them get back to you with whatever, how they work, and then say, okay, would you mind like starting off with Barter? Like, how would that work? Would you be okay with like one Instagram update or maybe just an Insta story update and we'll send you some stuff for free? We'll let you choose what you want. And as a brand, you know, when an influencer writes to you and says ki hume Barter karna hai, I tell my clients all the time that it's not, when I say I want to do Barter, it doesn't mean that you have to share your entire lookbook with me, okay? You can tell me that, okay, these are the 10 products that we can let you choose from because that's what our marketing budget allows. Because as an influencer, when you're writing to a brand, you have to understand that someone has, you know, it's a fashion label has just made a garment. You don't know how that garment is made. You don't know what goes into that. Literally, like, just the basics. There is cloth involved. There is dyeing involved. There are pattern making stuff that's involved. There are artisans who are actually stitching the damn thing that's involved. The amount of research that goes into actually coming up with the design, a pattern on the basis of which then you actually make a dress. There's a lot of work that goes into it. So it's not as easy as saying, arre 5000 ki dress hai, I'm charging 80,000 for an Instagram update, banta nahi hai. You can't really say that. See, when someone says that, for example, an influencer is charging 80k for an Insta update, it's not literally just for the update, right? There is photography involved, there is experience involved, the platform involved, who is the audience that you're reaching out to. So you have to apply that same thing to the brand's product. वो प्रोडक्ट कैसे बना है, किधर से आया है, इट्स नॉट जस्ट सेइंग कि अरे एक ड्रेस ही तो है, राइट? सो एज अ ब्रांड यू कैन सेट अ कैप ऑन वैल्यू एंड से दैट ओके लुक आई कैन नॉट अफोर्ड टू गिव अवे अ प्रोडक्ट वर्थ मोर देन 20k फॉर एग्जांपल एंड दैट्स फाइन द इन्फ्लुएंसर माइट बी लाइक दैट्स नॉट वर्थ माय टाइम सो दैट्स ऑल्सो फाइन बट आई एम सेइंग यू हैव टू आस्क एंड यू हैव टू मेक ऑल दीज रूल्स एंड से दैट लुक ब्रो आई'ड लव टू डू अ कोलैब विद यू एंड एज अ ब्रांड आई अप्रिशिएट योर प्लेटफॉर्म. But at this point in time, I can only afford giving you like a dress worth 20k or maybe two dresses worth 10 grand each or something. Now that 10 grand might be MRP and you can get into like whatever details there, etc. But that's up to you. So there's nothing wrong with Barter as such. Consent is key. So if you have asked them and you have both come to a mutual understanding and then you go ahead with Barter, that's fine. Like, do it. Like, I most of the times I do a lot of Barter with brands that I want to work with as an initial thing because I really like their garments and I want to wear that shit and I want some new stuff in my wardrobe. There's nothing wrong with being like, acha apna wardrobe banane ke liye tum Barter kar rahe ho. Ha. Like, I'm saying it. Isme matlab, what is there to be ashamed of? It's I'm providing value to the brand and the brand is providing value to me. If the brand feels that the value provided me is equal to the value provided by them, what's the problem? We're sorted, right? It's not just about money ki are dress to sirf 5000 ki thi usne free mein matlab insta update kar diya to hume zyada value mil gayi theek hai aapko aise lagta hai whatever but if both parties are happy with that I mean whatever yeah who cares so it's that's why I always say that you know working for free is very different from working on barter basis in any case as long as it's consensual I don't see a problem either ways if I put out on my social network and say I'm looking for barter collaborations and 50 people write to me and say okay yeah let's do this That's fine. I mean, I wrote out, they responded to it. It's consensual. I'm not forcing somebody to say, no, I am Naina and so you must barter. No, I don't want to get work on barter. Please pay me. My favorite hashtag. Hashtag fuck you pay me. So yeah, I mean, and this was one of the most constructive Instagram exchanges I have ever had. So I'm very grateful for that. If you guys want to like discuss anything, you can always reach out to me on Instagram DM. If it's full of shit, I'll probably just decline the message. In which case then you can like email me. My email is there everywhere. And thanks for listening again to another episode of the Naina Redhu Experience. If you have more questions about barter, you want to get into more details, etc., feel free to leave comments on my blog, on my YouTube, like anywhere. I mean, I'm there like on all social media. And thanks for listening. Bye.